The Gospel Light Technology Department welcomes you to our presentation. We're excited to have this opportunity to demonstrate the inner workings of our group. Now, there are many preconceived notions of how our department functions, and contrary to many opinions, we don't spend our time watching movies, playing video games, talking aimlessly, or other distractions used to whittle away the time. In fact, our team is constantly on the go. Our ever-present challenge is to keep current with the latest technology, remain diligent against the latest security threats, and all the while maintaining a positive, service-oriented approach with the entire company. So, it's with humble spirit and gracious attitude we present our modest offering. We hope this video will help give you insight into the daily workings of the Gospel Light Technology Department. Thank you, and enjoy.
So I've been doing help desk now for about 3 years. It's pretty good, pretty exciting. Every day is a different day. I get on the average 15 to 30 help desk requests a day, and most of them are pretty standard, pretty routine. I'm able to troubleshoot most of them.
Oh, hey, Tony, I just have a quick problem for you. I need you.
Use the help desk, Steve! Woo!
What's up, Tony?
What's up, Joe? Sorry, Steve. You really should use the help desk.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Hey, I was wondering if we could add that photo to the First Place website.
Well, the color profile of that encapsulated postscript is really going to choke the Swift. I guess we could drop a preloader in there, which is really just an indefinite loop that looks at the number of bytes loaded and assigns it a variable relative to the total size of the Swift.
I'm with you.
Then we could embed that flash file into the hypertext markup language page with a sniffer.
Sniffer?
To scope the user's operating system for the flash plugin and the appropriate browser.
Right, what?
I just think that over the Terminal Connect protocol in our target market, that download just isn't really viable.
Hey guys, can I help? I speak geek.
Oh yeah, thanks. I think.
I was just telling him that this bitmap's gonna rasterize really poorly and our core users operate around 1 gigahertz with no fat pipes, yo.
Why are you preloading Swifts when you can just store the raster data as MIME attachment and parse it through from a structured query language database via XML?
Won't that cause the load balancers to trip over the firewall's border routing?
Not if you make it a session object.
Of course. A session object.
Yeah. All right.
Can you make the picture smaller?
Sure. Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
He's going to SSH over a new encapsulated PostScript. You'll need to change mod it to 777 if you want to push it server-side with PHP.
Okay. We might run into some issues when the config file pulls the headers into the Perl module. So we can expect to RMF the SSL by hitting the VPN with 802.11g and DDRing the G and FNR vector.
Okay, you're all set.
All right, thanks.
What a bunch of geeks.
Hey, Bill, is there something wrong with the network? I've been getting complaints that it's running kind of slow today.
I don't know. Let me take a look at it. Let's see what's going on. Looks like we do have a problem. It says the server's down. So let's go take a look at it.
Okay.
Here it is.
Not good. Now what are we gonna do?
Yeah, no problem. I've got it covered.
Okay.
Just got the new iHamster from the Apple Store.
Cool.
I hear it's a better version than the other one.
So are we good then?
Yeah, we're good to go.
All right, great. Ow! Oh, I won again. Oh, it's Mark. Shh. Oh, hi, Mark. Yeah, we got the network up and running again. Oh, what'd we do? It's a highly technical thing. It had something to do with the session object, so Yeah. Yeah, well, we had to put in a little overtime, but, you know. Yeah, but, yeah, we don't mind. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye.
Dude, what do you think would happen if Mark found out the whole company's being run by a hamster?
I don't even want to think about it.
Me either.
Yeah, let's just go get some Mountain Dew.
Oh, Tony, I'm so glad you're here. I know I should go through the help desk, but I really need your help. I really need this file, and Amy sent it over to me, and it was corrupt. And I told her to send it again to me. She sent it to me twice. No, actually three times, and I still couldn't open it up. And I know maybe she can put it on the server, but if she puts it on the server, what if there's this funky little virus on it, and it, like, corrupts everyone else's documents? So I thought I'd come over here. I mean, it's an emergency. Do you think you could...
Ain't no time for jibber-jabbering. Use the help desk, Marisa.
Sup, Tony?
Sup, Joe?
Well, that's odd. Something's wrong with the server. Hey, Tony. Have you seen Bill or Steven around?
They're not here right now. They went to an off-site. You'd probably get Steven on his phone.
All right, thanks.
Hello? David? Oh, yeah. Actually, he's busy right now. But I'll have him take a look at it as soon as he gets back. Hey, Bill.
Hey, Steven.
David needs you to take a look at something.
All right.
Something wrong with the servers.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's take a look. Oh, there it is, right there. It's obvious, man. The server's down.
Can you fix it?
Yeah, I can fix it.
Take care, buddy.
Well, looks like he fixed it.
Wipeout!
Tired of your monotonous job? Feel like you're going nowhere? Looking for a way out? Maybe you should consider an exciting career in the fast-paced world of information technology. Exciting world of IT, you'll enjoy respect from your co-workers. Flexible work environment and competitive compensation plans. You will be a team builder using your advanced expertise solving complex daily issues.
Hey, Mike!
Hey, Tony! Hey, you've been doing such a good job around here. Wanted to thank you. Here, have a big sack of money.
Again?
Don't delay. Join IT today, and you too could start enjoying the tremendous benefits and prestige of being an information technology specialist.
When I first got to Gospelite, I'd never used a Mac before. Everyone said it'd come real easily, but I had some trouble. Computer, take me to the internet. Luckily for me, Steven was able to help me become a Mac master.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
I'm a productive member of the Gospel Light tech team.
Hey, Tony, listen, I'm sorry to bother you, but I've got this big project due and I'm having trouble with my PowerPoint. And I need to print out 2 slides per page, and I know there's a way to do it because I've done it on the PC, but I just can't find it on the Mac. At home on my PC, I'm able to quickly print 2 slides on a page. Maybe it's because I have a Lexmark printer at home. I know we use HP printers here, but that shouldn't make a difference, right? Well, I just know that there's probably an easy solution, but if I could get 2 slides per page, that would really save on printing costs. I tried to change the size of the slides, but that only made it smaller on the page. But still, only one per page. I think it has something to do with the session object. You know, I'll just put in a request with the help desk. Sorry to bother you.
What's up, Tony?
What's up, Joe?
Hi, and welcome to Web Talk with Josh Talbot. And now, here's your host, Josh Talbot.
Hi, welcome to Web Talk. I'm your host, Josh. Ever wonder how to get rid of those pesky pop-up ads? Do you want to know how to quickly and efficiently download the internet? On Web Talk, we talk about the issues that matter most. Let's go to our emails. Looks like we've got one here from Dave. Dave says, Dear WebTalk, where do you go to find great recipes online? Love your show. Thanks for your help. Dave. Good question, Dave. I usually go to an internet search engine, like Google or Yahoo. Go to the engine, type in what you need, and it'll take you right to it. Hope that helps. Let's go to another email. We've got one here from Elvira Birch. Buy your Rolexes for only $24.99? Best prices on the market just for you? Life support? Extended warranty? Well, thanks, Elvira. It's these awesome deals from fans like you that make the internet wholesome, friendly, and safe. Let's take a call. Who's on the line?
Hi, Josh. It's Jim.
Hi, Jim. What can we do for you?
Well, I've got a question for you, Josh. With all the websites out there, I can't seem to find the pictures I want.
I'm sorry, Jim. That's not a question. Let's take another call. Who's on the line?
Hey, Josh. It's Mike.
Hey, Mike. How you doing?
You know, Josh, I'm new to web design, and I'd like to know where you get all of your creative ideas.
Mike, that is a great question.
I think it's very vital to rock around. That's right. On top. It's tricky. It's tight. Here we go. It's tricky to rock around. To rock around. That's right. On time. It's tricky.
Great question, Mike. Well, we've got time for one more question here on Web Talk. Let's go to our mailbag. Shane from Quigsville writes, Dear Web Talk, the internet has really got me down. All the pop-up ads, the spam, the negativity. I'm thinking of just calling it quits. What do I do? Hanging by a thread, Shane. Well, Shane, don't lose heart. I go through those web valleys too. In fact, I wrote a little song just to get me through the hard times.
I love the web, I don't know about you. Do some online shopping and buy a kazoo. Send some chat with some friends. Don't have to be cool because I can pretend on the web. I love the web. Yes, I love the web.
My head's out of frame, huh?
Yeah, you are.
This is my mouth, I will.
Hey, Bill, is there something wrong with the network? he's making faces at me. I'm gonna be standing here the rest of my life. I'm waiting, I'm still trying to look inquisitive, like, oh yes, will you just get up?
Okay. Good then?
Yeah, we're good to go.
All right. Great. Hey! Oh, that's not good. Now it's what okay. Are we gonna do?
That's okay. I've got to go. Nice men have second tries.
Hold it. Two, one more, Stephen, one more.
I'll build the SSI to accept the non-Unicode MIME. We might run into some issues when the config
smiling.
I'm
not
smiling.
That's
a smile, man.
Come on, you're on.
Okay, you ready?
Oh, Tony, I'm so glad you're here. I can't do it with Joe sitting there. He cracks me up. Okay, I can do it. Oh, Joe,
Hi, welcome to WebHost.
Dude.
Hi, I'm Josh. See how bad I am at this? Oh my gosh. It leaves me. Hold on. Thanks for the help, Dave. Good.